speeches, man, that they get me hyped. I'm like, hell yeah, like, let's go, man. I wish I could speak like that.
So before you turn pro, they told you you're not going to make it.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Did you know that?
I heard that plenty of times.
Well, you know, in life with many aspects, you know, especially when it's something that seems to be, you know, so far out of reach, you know, you know, you're an attorney, you want to study to be that. Of course, people are going to get behind that because, you know, you could work in the private sector, the public sector, there's so many opportunities. Obviously, as a professional prize fighter, it's far and few between. That being said, though, to me, with kids, I think that you should apply whatever you want to do, whether you make it or you don't make it, give everything you have, because at the end of the day, you want to be able to look yourself in the mirror and say, hey, you know what? I gave everything I had, and either you made it or you didn't make it, but you have no regrets. And then you can move on to whatever facet in life that you want to do. But if you don't give everything, it would always eat at you, man. Maybe I could have done this. Maybe I could have done that. And those are the type of things you don't want to live with regret.
That's true. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but Tank is the one that wanted this fight because people complained to him. He turned pro at 126, and they complained you only fight little guys. He's like, let me go after the baddest 140 with the belt. Did you know that?
Nah, but I mean, you know, it's
not surprising.
Yeah, it's not surprising, you know. Like I've said before, you know, I respect what he's trying to do. You know, he's trying to prove a point, and the move he's making, it's a move that not a lot of fighters, you know, would ever think about. You know, but at the end of the day, man, he has, you know, a hard fight in front of him. You know, I have a hard fight with him, and you know, come the 26th, the best manager is gonna walk out of the ring, you know, with their hand raised.
Do you have any message for Tank or his team if they're watching?
No message. I mean, you know, they'll. I know they'll be ready come the 26th, and I'm going to be ready.
Tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram.
Instagram, I'll say Twitter, but I'm not as active on Twitter, but Instagram, boxer_barrios.
At I am Omar Juarez, Instagram and Twitter.
Bob.
Old school, no social media, baby.
Rick Boxer 210.
Instagram, Rick Boxer.
Rick Huerta Nunez on Facebook.
And Coach, where they follow you?
Ringside_.
All right, make sure to follow all of them. Stay tuned. June 26th, pay-per-view on Showtime. Before I forget, what do you guys think of all this YouTube boxing? Mayweather fighting Logan and...
I'm not a fan of all of them, but, you know, there is some positive. You know, it is bringing a fan base that has never really, you know, tried to watch boxing. But, you know, I'm not really too crazy about it.
Anybody you want to fight that's a celebrity?
Me?
Yeah. No rapper, actor, singer.
Shit, if any of them want to fight me, man, I need the cash, man. Shit,
hey, man. The TikTokers, if they're not lying, because they...
YouTuber wants to fight me,
check
shit,
this out.
Man, come on, let's do it.
The TikTokers told me they're going to pay $5 and $6 million.
Hey, you know what?
Turning pro, $5 and $6 million.
I'll tell you what, I'm all for it. It brings eyeballs to the sport. To me, boxing is the greatest sport on earth. And when it brings people to see what kind of sport it is, and the entertainment value, and it's one-on-one. It's not the team. This guy, he missed the pass. This guy did this. And it's the ultimate competition, whether it's, you know, guys at this level or guys at that level. I give respect to anybody who wants to do a one-on-one combat at any level. You got to give their respect to climb in there and do what these guys do.
It's not easy. Boxing's not easy. People think it's a game, but it's not. You play basketball, play baseball, play.
That's right.
You don't play boxing.
Yeah, you don't play the boxing, hurt business. Man. This is, you know, one of the only sports, you know, you can go into the ring, you know, and not come out. And, I mean, I feel like that's definitely overlooked by, you know, a lot of fans and everything. I've been asked plenty of times, you know, do you fight based on the crowd reaction? And I tell them no, man, because straight up boxing fans don't care if we make it out of that ring alive or not.
Or if you're damaged, and then afterwards,
then they just forget about you, then they move on to, you know, the next fighter.
That's why it's important to be smart with money. Mm-hmm. Do you have any businesses, any investments, Mario? Do you do away from boxing?
Yeah.
What do you have? Tell people, shout out your businesses.
I don't have like extra businesses, you know, but I mean,
you're smart with your money.
Yeah.
That's it's very important, Bob, because too many fighters, unfortunately.
Hey, you know. I think that's one thing that I've always tried to pride myself in with Louie and Al is preaching to these guys about doing good with their money, you know, like what we did with Guerrero, what we've done with Laura. They've been in good financial positions. But at the end of the day, you know, people got choices that they got to make. You can lead a horse to water, you can't make them drink. But for the most part, thank God most of my fighters that we've worked with have done
well
financially, and I'm proud about that.
Okay, if you had $1 million to burn, what are you burning it on?
I mean, I don't want to burn it.
You would. Omar, you're smiling. Man, you know what you would get.
Oh, I'd buy a house, man.
That's good.
That's my main priority right now, buying a house.
Bitcoin?
Hey. Yeah, really
that's not bad, house. Right?
You know how many houses in San Antonio you can buy with $1 million?
Yes.
In Texas?
At least 5. Nice ones.
That's crazy. In LA, you could buy a window.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you have it. Stay tuned. Mario Barros and Cap for Javonta Davis. FLOYD reporting.com. Zekbach reporting. So, Mario, let me ask you.